So the constraints of this problem are the ambassador instructs you to invite Teju or exclude Qatar. The vice ambassador wants you to invite Qatar or Romania or both. A recent diplomatic incident means that you cannot invite both Romania and Peru. Who do you invite? This is a simple problem, and we will try to find out a computational solution to such simple problems. Such simple problems arise in mathematics every time. Okay. So, how do we reduce this problem? We reduce this problem by converting our statement into mathematical statements. So, the ambassador instructs you to invite Peru or exclude Qatar. So, we ignore that Peru is coming. So, Peru comes, or this symbol is for or exclude Qatar. So, there is negation.
Right this side.
Yeah. The vice ambassador wants you to invite Qatar or Romania or both. So, either Qatar can come, Romania can come, or both can come. This statement is satisfied. And then, a recent diplomatic incident means that you cannot invite both Romania and Peru. So, Romania and Peru, they both cannot come. So, there is a division of them. Now, this problem, I give you the solution. Who do you invite? P, Q, and minus R. If you see, if we invite Peru, Qatar, and exclude Romania, or if we don't invite Peru and Qatar and invite Romania, the problem will be satisfied. But this is a simple problem, so we can think directly. But imagine a problem which is very huge. The problems which arise in computer science and electronics, they have these variables in millions. For example, you have the computer chip. Inside a computer chip, there are millions of transistors and connected. How do you decide that computer chip will work properly? You have to make a logic that if this particular transistor is working and that transistor is working, because inside computer it's all like odds and ends, or gates and AND gates, they're all gates. So when there are millions of variables, then we have to use computers, and that's where the satisfactory problem comes. The propositional satisfactory problem is defined as, given a propositional formula, does it have a model? Which means, can it be satisfied in any way? I mean, there can be a problem which cannot be satisfied, like the problem which we had earlier. Might be there cannot be no solution. Like, invite Pakistan and don't invite Pakistan. Either you can invite Pakistan or you cannot invite Pakistan, both things cannot happen together. So, we have to see if there is a satisfying assignment or not. So, this satisfactory problem is the first decision problem shown to be NP-complete. NP-complete problems are those computational problems which are very hard. They cannot be solved in polynomial time. They cannot be solved in polynomial time. So, that's what satisfactory problem is. And an important feature of the NP-complete problem is that if you can solve one NP-complete problem, you can solve all the NP-complete problems, because problem interconvertible. So, solution of this problem currently has an award of $1 million. So, if you can solve this problem in polynomial time, the government is going to give you $1 million. So, because it's so hard, it hasn't been solved yet, but our effort in solving this problem is to solve it in the best possible manner. So, we cannot solve it in polynomial time, so we use heuristics. We make approximations. We try to reduce our time. So, how close we can get to attaining the polynomial time. Okay. So, in this problem, we will focus on solving this problem in a Clausian normal form, the conjunctive normal form. What is a conjunctive normal form? Conjunctive normal form is the conjunction of clauses. What is a clause? Clause is a disjunction of literals. And what is a literal? Literals are Boolean atoms. Either a Boolean atom is zero, a variable which can be assigned 0, 1, or the negation of it. So, the disjunction of literals and the conjunction of those literals form a conjunctive normal formula. Okay, so a literal is, these are all examples of CNFs, conjunctive normal formula. Okay, KCNF means that each of those problems has K literals in it. 3CNF means there are 3 literals in it. And okay. I think it's
Thanks, guys.
Okay, I just really gather what is CNF. I think I don't know yet. What is CNF? CNF formula is the conjunction of detection of clauses. For example, A plus B plus C. These are what clauses, these are neutrals, and these are or times, these means the plus represents or, and these are times. That means if one of these neutrals is positive value, the clause will be satisfied, and we need to satisfy all the clauses so that the entire formula gets satisfied. That is a CNF clause. This is CNF form.
Sir,
this bar represents negation. Yes, sir? Sir, this is that part. Yes, sir. Okay, so we can the propositional formulas, not all the Boolean formulas are propositions. We also have first order logic and second order logic. But all the Boolean, all the first order logic or all the Boolean formulas can be converted into the propositional logic. They can be converted into propositional logic. For example, this formula is not in the CNF form. This formula is not in CNF form. We can convert it into CNF form using De Morgan's law, or choosing we have if the formula has quantifier, first order logic always has quantifier. We can reduce the formula into simple CNF form by using common manipulation mathematical techniques. So my point is that all the Boolean formulas can be reduced into CNF. And of course I told that all the LP computing problems can be reduced into this satisfactory problem. So we have a simple CNF representation for all our computational problems. Okay. So how do we solve SAT? There are several methods which we researchers have tried to solve SAT, and these are some of the systematic methods that exist. Most famous of these is the David Putnam procedure, then local SAT method, and also exotic method. Exotic methods are like using DNA computing or quantum computing, which gives us infinite computational power to solve such computational problems. But you usually don't have such strong computational power. So what we rely on are these two techniques mostly, and that's what we work on. And the main focus of this presentation will be on the most famous and most popular technique to solve this satisfactory problem. That is the David Putnam procedure. Okay, this is an example of how simple SAT problem can be solved. We will draw the entire truth table and solve it. But that's not how we can solve big problems. Okay, so David Putnam procedure, introduced by David and Putnam in 1960. So these two were mathematicians. They didn't have any knowledge of computer science. So what they did was, they tried to find out a mathematical solution to this problem. What they did was they used resolution procedure to solve these Boolean formulas. What is resolution procedure? If you have a CNF formula written like this, what you can do is you can start eliminating the variables. For example, in this problem, if A is negative A and A, both are A. So what you can do is you can combine these two formulas to write B plus C. This is resolution. I mean, if there are two problems, if A may non-negative value, negative value. So we can combine this, get a simple formula, and that is, you can reduce the entire formula. It's very simple. That's what these two mathematicians did. But then came the two computer scientists, Logman and Lovell, and these two tried to convert this solution into a computational algorithm. So they suggested some techniques which we will look into. Okay, so this is an example of a CNF formula.